Today, inshallah, we are going to continue from where we stopped under geometry. Last time, we took perimeters of plane shapes, where we talked about perimeter of square, perimeter of rectangle, perimeter of circle, perimeter of polygons. And I told you perimeter is the distance around a shape. So, and I also gave you different formulae, and you know that there's no special formula for perimeter. Just know that the distance around any shape is perimeter. You can use your addition to do that, but you can also use some formulae like the perimeter of a square is 4L. You can use 4L, 4 times L. We can say perimeter of a rectangle, 2 brackets, L plus B. Exactly. So we also talked about finding the sides of different shapes. Like now, you can be asked to look for the length if perimeter is given. You know, in the video I sent to you, I've discussed that. And I gave you homework. Your homework correction will be sent to you tomorrow, inshallah, Kareem. And I believe all of you have submitted. Now, today, areas of shapes. What do you mean by areas of shapes? Area. Area is the total surface of a given shape. The surface of a given shape. So it could be plane shapes or solid shape. So when we get to areas of solid shape, that's what we're talking about. Surface area, but now we just stand on the areas of shapes. Now let's take the different types of shapes and how to go about calculating the areas. We'll take square for examples. The first shape we are taking is square. It's a plane shape. We've done the properties of each shape. You know, this is a square. This is length, 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 length. If it were to be perimeter, I'm going to add all the lengths together. That would be L plus L plus L plus L to give us 4L. But if you want to look for the surface, that means the total surface of this place. That's the meaning of the area, all this place. So if I have to look for the total surface, just as I'm having my square like this. If I want to look for the surface area, I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All the squares inside here will be the surface area of this square. And that will be 6 centimeter or meter square. Is that clear? So when you are looking for area of a square, don't disturb yourself. Just bring a formula that you use. And this formula will be length. Sorry, this L is length. Length times length. Or we call it L square. It means if your L is 5 centimeters, you can get your area from there. They may put another 5 centimeter here. It depends. If it is only one they gave you, you can go. You can look for your area. Just say 5 times 5. You know, length, that means the side. 5 centimeters times 5 centimeters. And that will give us 25 centimeters squared. While we're getting square, centimeters times centimeters. Sorry, centimeters times centimeter give me centimeter raised to power 2. That means in two places. Is that clear? That's not the simple method or simple way of calculating the area of a square. Is it clear? So when you're asked to look for area, just multiply one length by itself. Exactly. And you don't forget that this square will always have equal sides. So if you take 5, for example, just know that the 5 you took is already the 5 in the other part of the length, and that way. So the second shape we are taking under area of shapes is rectangle. Rectangle. This is a rectangle. It can be vertical or horizontal. So that is it. The difference between square and rectangle, you all know that it has the opposite sides are equal. This place is, if this place is the length, this will be the breadth, and this will be the length, this will be the breadth. So the perimeter of this is 2 brackets length times breadth, at length plus breadth. That means 2 brackets L plus B. But the area, if you want to calculate the area of this rectangle, it means you want to know the total surface of this shape. You are going to do what? You are going to say that A, which is area, length, multiplied by breadth. So if there are anybody asking, what is the formula for area of a rectangle? You say length times breadth. Why are we using breadth here? It's still the same thing with this one. The reason we are using this breadth here is because this length is longer and this breadth is shorter. So that is why we are having 2 different dimensions. Here we have only one. You can call it length. Exactly. So here we are having length and breadth. It's still the same equation we use for them. So now, if I try to give you an example under this, when the question is given that the length and breadth of a rectangle are 18 centimeters and 16 centimeters, find its area. You want to look for the area of this shape. What you have to do is just bring your formula. Area is equal to length times breadth. Or you say L times B. Is it clear? So you just put your L to be 18 centimeters multiplied by 16 centimeters. So if you calculate your work, 18 times 16, you are going to get 288, which is your final answer, 288 centimeters squared. That means centimeters times centimeter. You know, in perimeter, we have centimeter and meter, but the unit for area is centimeter squared or meter squared. Is that clear? That's the second shape. L times L here, or L squared. Length times breadth for rectangle. So the third one we are taking now is the triangle. The triangle. You know, when we did perimeter of triangle, I told you that perimeter of the triangle is simple. You just add all the sides together to get the perimeter. But now, under area, you have a formula that you will be using. This is a triangle. This place, from this place is called base, or you call it baseline. That means the base of the triangle. The base of the triangle. And this line from here to here is the height of the triangle. Is it clear? So in triangle we have base and height. So the formula now will now be area is equal to half base times height. That's the area of a triangle. Half BH. Is it clear? Half BH. There's a reason why this half is here, but I will not be doing the explanation here, maybe later or because of time. And this is not part of what we are treating. We are to treat the area of each shape. The third one is the triangle, which I have already given you the formula. You can say A is equal to half base times height. What you have to do to get your answer, you'll be given the base and you'll be given the height. Just put base where B is, the number they gave you, and put the number they gave you for height where H is. Then you do what? You calculate your work. Now let me give you example under this one. This is the third shape we are taking. Area of this triangle. Find the area of this triangle. I'll send this note to you. Find the area of this triangle whose baseline, what do you mean by baseline? This place from here to here is the baseline. The baseline is 16 centimeters and the height, which is also called perpendicular height, is 12 centimeters. Find the area of this triangle. Now you see that this is not perimeter, it's area. Since I've given you the formula, just bring the formula. Formula will help you, it will make your work easier. Is that clear? So half times B times H. Is it clear? Base, B is the base, while H is the height. And they've given us the base to be 16 and height to be 12. So you now put your numbers there. B is what? 16. And H, which is the height of the triangle, is 12 over 1 over 1. Then you break. 2 here, 1. 2 in 16, 8. We are now having 1 times 8 times 12. And 1 times 8 times 12 is what? 1 times 8 is 8. 8 times 12 is 96 over 1. You know this one? So and this will give us 96 centimeters squared. It's as simple as that. Just break the numbers and get your final answer. So that is the third triangle, third shape. The next one we are going to is the parallelogram. Parallelogram is the fourth shape after we've taken square, rectangle, triangle. So parallelogram, I believe you know how to draw parallelogram. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral, a square, and you know it has parallel lines, opposites, sides are parallel, that's why it is called parallelogram. Look at this, this is parallel to this. And this is parallel to this. So, and if the height, this is the height, or we call it perpendicular height. And from here to here is the baseline. And let me use capital letter for this. And this will be baseline from here to here. So the formula we will be using for this is this. Area is equal to baseline times perpendicular. So we just represent and the perpendicular height with H. So it's just as if you are length times breadth. So baseline times perpendicular height. That is the formula for parallelogram, area of a parallelogram. So they will ask you, what is the area of the shape below? And they give you a parallelogram. Then you just go look for the baseline and the perpendicular height. Then you do what? You multiply the two to get your answer. Let's see this question. This example. They gave us 7 centimeters here. And they gave us 11 centimeters. Then I ask us, what is the area of this shape? They may not even ask, they may not say parallelogram, but in as much you know how to draw a parallelogram, you can recognize it. You will just use your what? Formula for parallelogram, which is baseline times perpendicular height. And what is the baseline? From here to here is the baseline, which is 11 centimeters, and we have 7 centimeters, which is the height. Then when you multiply your work, you get 11 times 7, 77 centimeters square. Don't forget your square. We are green area. That is that one. That is the fourth shape. The fifth one is the trapezium. Trapezium. And I believe you know how to draw your trapezium. This is it. It can come in any form. You see, in trapezium, we have a pair of parallel lines. What do you mean by a pair of parallel lines? It's only this place and this place that are parallel. Is that clear? And this place, you name it A and B. So this A and B is called sum of parallel lines. What do I call it? Sum of parallel lines. If I write A plus B, it means sum of the parallel lines. They may give you your question that the sum of parallel lines of the trapezium is 40. Just know that they have already done it for you. They have already added A plus B for you. Just put it in your answer and your question and do it. But what do you need again? You need the what? The height. The height of this parallelogram is H. So that gives us a formula, which is half into bracket A plus B H. This A plus B is what? Is the sum of the parallel lines. So in some questions, they may give you the A and the B. You have to put your A and the B there, then add it together yourself. In another question, they might have done it for you. What you have to do is just remove this A plus B and put that sum there. Then you calculate your work. So the fifth formula I'm giving you now is formula for trapezium, which is half into bracket A plus B, close the bracket, H. If numbers are together or letters, just know it is what? Multiplication. Like this half is half times this bracket times H. Is that clear? So that is that on the formula for trapezium. Let's now take an example under this one, trapezium. Find the area of the trapezium below. So it's in the note. So that's, I'm drawing it now. We have this shape. This is 5 centimeters. This is the angle, right angle. We have 10 centimeters to be the B. While the second one is 6 centimeters, they ask us to look for this area, the area of this shape. The first thing to do here is bring the formula. Anytime you have to look for area or perimeter, you know the formula. Bring the formula first, then start applying start working on it. I'll start looking at the information given. Now, this is the, you don't let me put multiplication. Just know that it is times. When we get to our solution, when we get to this, so that we know how to. Half into A plus B H. So that, what is A, what is B? Nobody will tell you. Even they may not even write it on top. It may be in a sentence. If they say the lines of the parallel lines of a parallelogram is 5 centimeters, 6 centimeters respectively, just know that the 5 is the first one on top, while the 6 is the one below. Is that clear? Or they may have given you the sum. They might have added 6 and 10 together to give you 16. But here, we have the A, the first line, and the second line. We have the B. So we have to put it here. A is what? 6. And B is what? 10. Why the height is there too? 5 centimeters. Just put it there. Can you see that? As simple as that. Then you continue step by step. 6 plus 10, 16 over 1. 5 over 1. So can you see this? What you now do here is what? Divide these two by this 16. 2 here, 1. 2 here, what? 8. You know, it's just like the area we did, the triangle we did the other time. The only difference between the trapezium and the triangle is this A plus B. In the other, we have half base times height, only B and height. Exactly. But this one, you must have the sum of the two parallel lines. So 8 times 5 here is now what? 40 over 1. Now we are having 40 what? 40 centimeters squared. And that is the answer to that question. Please look at it very well. It is not even hard at all. If you understand what I've explained, you can do any question under that area of parallelogram. Look at it. If they are giving A plus B, put it. If they are not given, if they have already summed it for you, put it there. Sometimes they may ask you to look for the sum of the parallel lines. That's our next, in our next class, we are going to treat that. Sometimes they ask you to look for the height. They will have given you the area. How will you go about it? So those are the things we have to look at in the next class. Now, the sixth shape, and that will be the last shape, and that is a circle. What to take, because a circle is also a plane shape, so we'll not exempt that. We have to take that too. Because in our last class, under perimeter of shape, we took perimeter of circle to be 2 pi r or pi d. But in this area now, we are going to look at another formula for area of a circle, which is pi r squared. The difference is just this square, and the last one is 2 pi r. This one is pi r squared. So if you want to remember this formula very well, what you just need is square for area, and that the other one does not have square. Now, how do we apply this? You know this to be what? Pi. Pi will always be given to you. 22 over 7, 22 over 7, 3 over 1 over 7, or 3.14. These are the values for pi. So, and it will be given to you. One of it will be given to you in the question. So, area of a circle is what? Pi r squared. So, all these things, you have to what? Commit them to memory. You put them in your brain, you will not forget. If they wake you from your slumber and I say, do you know what is area of a circle? You just open your mouth. Pi r squared. What's perimeter of the circle? 2 pi r or pi d? Can you see that? With that, you will like mathematics. But if you don't know formulae, you will not enjoy mathematics because you will be racking your brain for some things. Now, let's continue. Examples. Find the area of the circular field. They may not even say circle. Circular field. Circular field is this circle. Circular field, whose range radius is, let me write this. Find the area of a circular field whose radius is 7 meters. And you have to take pi to be what? 22 over 7. Can you see that? I told you the word is give you. Now, in any question, the first thing to do is do what? What do they ask me to look for? Can you see that? Find. This verb is what you should always look for in question. Find the area. What is that? Is it perimeter? Is it area? That's the first thing. Find the perimeter. Okay, find the area. Okay, I know what they ask you to look for. Area. Area of what? You know, in area, they always ask you area of plane shapes. So, area of this shape, circular. Your mind will now be at rest. Okay, I cannot calculate. Since I know formula for what? For area of a circle. So, the first thing to bring is your what? The formula for that. And that will be what? Area is equal to pi r squared. Then you now use it. Pi is what? Pi, 22 over 7. 22 over 7. Times my radius. They gave me radius. If they are giving diameter, divide by 2. Please, don't forget. Sometimes they may be giving diameter to be what? Diameter to be, the radius to be, this question is in diameter, in radius. Sometimes they will give you diameter, just divide by 2. So you now say, this one is radius, right? 7 times 7, because r square means r in two places. So then you break. 7 here, 1. We are now having 22 times 7. So our 22 times 7 is what? 154 centimeters, meters squared. So Now that you know the formula for, that's the answer. You know the formula for area of a circle. They may ask you semicircle and they may also ask you area of a quadrant. Don't forget, semicircle is half of a circle. Quadrant is where you divide the circle into this is a quadrant, this is another quadrant. We may even have another quadrant, another quadrant. It means when you divide the circle into four. So, how do you get the area of all this? It's by doing what? Just join 1 over 4 to this formula. If it is semicircle, 1 over 2, it will be 1 over 2 pi r squared. Can you see that? If it is a quadrant, they have to look for 1 over 4 pi r squared. Then you now what? You now use it. You now use this 2 to break any of the numbers at the numerator. Exactly. So that is how to get the even in perimeter. They ask you to look for perimeter of a semicircle or perimeter of a quadrant. Is that clear? So that is that on that. And let me stop here. But before I stop, there's one thing I want you to know. Under triangle, remember I told you half base times height is the formula for the area of the triangle. Sometimes they will ask you to look for the area of the shaded portion of a triangle. After you have looked for the whole area of the triangle, then you now divide by 2. Because this place is half of this triangle. Is that clear? Maybe I got, when I calculated for area of this maybe this place is 5, this place is 12. And I did it half base 12 times 5. 2 year 1, 2 year 6. Now I got 6 times 5, 30. If I'm to look for the shaded portion, I'm going to divide it by 2 because it's part of the what? It's half of this triangle. And that will give me what? 15 meter or centimeter square. Is it clear? So, question may come that way. And that is how you go about it. Now, I'm going to send your homework to you very soon, inshallah. So, if you have question, you can ask me. So far, so good. We have done the area of a